Hello everyone, and welcome back to our inventory system series in Godot 4. In this video, we will finally finish off our slot system by adding the functionality to drop our items back into our world. We'll start off by completing our remove items function in our global script, because we haven't finished that. So open up your project and let's head into global.gd. So just like with our add items function, we'll need to iterate through our inventory array and remove an item with a certain type and a certain effect, because that is our two most identifiable characteristics of our item's property. That being said, we'll need to add our item type and our item effect as parameters in our remove item function. Then, before we emit our signal, we will loop through our inventory. Then we're going to remove an item based on its effect and type, since those two properties are the most important properties that separate our items from one another. So we'll compare each item to these properties. We'll then need to decrease its quantity by 1, and if the quantity reaches 0, we'll remove the item from the inventory completely. It's almost exactly the same as what we did with our add item function, but instead of adding to the quantity of the item, we'll just remove 1 up until there's nothing left, and then we'll just empty the slot completely. I apologize for the error that you see on the screen right now. You see, I said item type and item effect when it should be our parameters that we passed. Then finally, we'll emit our signal and return true and return false by default, because if there's nothing to remove, we don't want to continue removing things. Okay, and that is our remove item function complete. Now, do you remember when we assigned our items to a group so that it doesn't overlap with each other when we drop them back into the world? Well, we're going to put that group to use now, because we're going to create a new function in our global script that will adjust the drop position of an item to prevent it from overlapping with other nearby items of the same group. This function will loop continuously until a valid drop position for our item has been found. Now, this function should also take a vector2 object called position as a parameter, as this vector2 object will represent the initial position where an item is intended to be dropped. So, let's create a new function called adjustDropPosition. So this position will basically just be the position that the game is checking each time it's trying to place down the item to see if it's valid. Now, within this function, we need to define a new variable that will create a circular area around the drop position. So this circle is basically our drop area, and our function will check this drop area for any other items to prevent overlapping when it tries to drop or place down an item. You can increase or decrease this radius. I'm just going to make it 100. Then we will get all of our nodes that belong to our items group, and we will assign them to an array. So now that we have our check radius and we have an array of all the items on our map that belong to the items group, we need to create a loop that will loop through this array and check whether or not the position of the item that we want to drop is less than the radius. In other words, is it within that spawn area? If this item is within the radius, it means that the item is too close to the drop position and it will overlap with another item. To combat this, we need to create a vector which has an offset that is still within the radius value. This allows us to place it close by, but not on top of other items. Now we'll add this offset to the original position of our item. We'll also then break out of a loop since a valid drop position has been found. Finally, we will return the drop position. Now that we have our function that will check for a valid location to drop our item on, we need to create another function that will actually drop our item. We will drop the item at the position that was passed from our adjustDropPosition function, and we'll drop it with the item data that it had originally when we picked it up. Before we can actually spawn this item, we need to have a way of getting that original data that the item had before we picked it up. To do this, we need to go back to our inventory item script and create a new function that will set the original item data back into the dropped item data. This means we'll drop the item with its original values. Now we can go back to our drop item function and call this function. We'll pass in our item data parameter as the data that should be added back to the item when it drops. After we've initiated our item and set the data that we want it to spawn with, we need to set its valid drop position and add the item as a child instance of the scene tree. Finally, we can go back to our inventory slot component and add the functionality to drop the item. First, we'll need to attach our drop button's press signal to our script. Now, if the drop button is pressed, we will initialize the drop position to be equal to the player's position. This means it will check for a valid drop location around the area where the player is. We only do this if the item is valid though, because once again, we don't want to drop an item that doesn't exist. We'll then give this item a drop offset of 50 pixels to the right of the player's position, but we'll also need to turn this offset based on the player's current rotation to ensure that the item is dropped in the direction that the player is facing. Finally, we will drop the item and remove it from our inventory by calling our global scripts that we just created. We'll also hide our usage panel. Now if we run our scene, we should be able to pick up and drop our items back into the world. Our items should also not overlap with each other. That is it for our slot component for now. In the next part, we will focus on our player component again as we finish off our functionality to actually use our inventory items. That is all for now, and I hope to see you in the next part.